Okay. In the last class, we learned that how the acceleration of the moon is variation. That means according to the Newton, the acceleration of the moon is inversely proportional to the square of the distance of the moon from the center of the earth. That means we can write, if A is the acceleration of the moon and R is the distance of the moon from the center of the earth. Okay, so all of you know very well, the force is the mass times of acceleration. Yes, if we assume M is the mass of the moon, so we can write F directly proportional to M by R square, where M is the mass of the moon. Okay, see, suppose all of you know very well, according to Newton's third law, with which force earth attracts moon, with that force only moon is also attracts the earth, with same force only. So from the Newton's third law, we can say the force between the earth and moon is proportional to the mass of the moon, and as well as that force only proportional to the mass of the earth also. So from this observation, we can say that force is directly proportional to the product of mass of the earth, which is denoted by capital M, and mass of the moon, small m, by R square. Now if we can this write as F is equals to some proportionality constant G into capital M into small m by R square, where G is called as a universal gravitational constant, constant. What is this value? 6.675 into 10 power minus 11 Newton meter square per kg square. So this Newton meter square per kg square is the SI unit of the universal gravitational constant. So we can write SI unit is Newton meter square per kg square, and as well as CGS unit is dyne centimeter square per gram square. Then what is the dimensional formula of the universal gravitational constant? M minus 1 L3 T minus 2. So this is the information about the universal gravitational constant. Okay, now from this we can derive the equation F is equals to G capital M into small m by R square. Okay, now from this Newton proposed the universal law of gravitation. Newton proposed universal law of gravitation. So Newton's universal law of gravitation. What is the Newton's universal law of gravitation? The force of attraction between two masses is directly proportional to product of their masses and inversely proportional to square of the distance between them, and acts along the line joining between them. Suppose here two bodies are there, mass m1, m2. These two are separated by the distance small r. Therefore, from the Newton's universal law of gravitation, the force of attraction between these two bodies is directly proportional to product of their masses m1 into m2 and inversely proportional to square of the distance between them. So F directly proportional to 1 by r square. So from the above two equations we can write F directly proportional to m1 into m2 by r square. So we can write from this equation F is equals to some proportionality constant g into m1 into m2 by r square, where g is already we discussed, where g is called as a universal gravitational constant. Okay, what are the limitations related to the universal gravitational constant? Universal gravitational constant, this Newton's universal law of gravitation holds good only for the point masses. Suppose if it is in the case of the extended objects, then how we can apply for the this extended object, this Newton's universal law of gravitation? At that time we can consider the total mass of the object is supposed to be concentrated at its center. Okay, so this Newton's universal law of gravitation only holds good for the point objects. In the case of the extended objects, we can say the total mass of the object is supposed to be concentrated at the center of mass. So based on that we can use this universal law of gravitation. Next, this universal law of gravitation holds good for large distances and as well as short distances also. Large comma short distances. This universal gravitational constant is a scalar quantity. This universal gravitational constant is a scalar quantity. In this name only there, that universal law of gravitation is a, that means that constant is constant throughout the universe. It does not vary from place to place. So g value is constant throughout universe, constant anywhere.